bill is going to be passed, almost passed. It is declared. Bill is a bill. It is a proposal before the 224 MLAs. But the act will be done. Without the act, the ordinance will be brought by the Bombay government. So, the point is, it is unwarranted in these circumstances when there are a lot of problems of unemployment, there are a lot of COVID problems, health problems, corruptions are growing more than 100%. It has become the precedent in the India. Karnataka is the largest the producer of the corruption. So instead of combating all these things and improving development of Karnataka, bringing this bill of anti-conversion. The conversion means it is not purposeful, it is a willful. It is their interest, it is their study, it is their devotion to the God, to the Ishwar, to the Jesus. That is that it comes through the study. Not certainly by the compulsion, by the coercion, by force, by alluding the things, it cannot be done. It was not done since prior independence. 1947 till that, there is a law. Nobody can pay money. Nobody can induce. Nobody can force for the kind of marriage.
The way in which in Kolar, they've stopped people from distributing material, stopped them, burnt religious books. What action has the police taken against these organizations? Instead of all this, the government wants to bring in a anti-conversion law. Let us be very clear, there is no such thing as forced conversion. Who a person believes, which God a person believes in, which faith a person believes in is their choice. It's my choice. The government has no business in interfering in it.
And it is shocking that in a state like Karnataka, where there has been no known any case which has successfully been convicted of anyone being forced to convert from any religion to any religion. So then what is their logic? So somebody is talking about Mr. Bulihatti Shekhar and his problem. My question is, why hasn't his mother come out and spoken? What about her privacy? What about her right to practice her freedom of religion? What about the dozens of families in Hosdurga's, his own, Bulihatti Shekhar's own constituency, where the Tahsildar has submitted boldly a report saying that there many families have converted, but there has been no force. They've done it out of their own desire to convert without any complaint. So it is constitutional. Even this law, they are saying no, only where there is force. So where is the force? Tell me, where is the logic? On what basis are they saying that there is a need for this law? First, there is no need for this law. There is no evidence, shred of evidence, that any forceful conversion has taken place.
Male and female agreed with the witnesses of their own family before either the sub-registrar or before the district magistrate. There is no law, there is no bill can prevent anything else, because it is the choice given. Otherwise, there is no government, there is no act, there is nothing. When it is going beyond the age and with the intention, with the permission of their own family, a single person is going to be converted with the consent of their family members, wife, children, no bill can prevent. But this is introducing now to induce many riots, many things, to appease the party, those who have given him the power, to Bombay government. And these opponents called Devagoda, Kumarasamy, DK and Siddaramaiah, these people, they have the rights, they have the people's mandate to go before the Bombay also and tell them this is the problem. If he is not conceded by him, they can themselves join among us the 75. They can defeat in the upper house. They can defeat the bill in the upper house with all their mighty, with all the power, by prevent it from becoming the bill, from becoming the act. Unless, even otherwise, this government can make it ordinance through the honorable governor. But the problem into this bill is, it is unwarranted, it is unnecessary, it is untimely, and it is the wish of the public, against the wish and constitutional rights of the thing. The article 25(1)(a) has the power. A man can eat, can dress, can convert, can live his life or her life according to their, not law, according to their wish.
Exactly, that's the question we are asking. When there's no forced conversion, why do you need a law? See, you need a law if there is something that's going wrong. There is no forced conversion, and if there's an act of force, there is the Indian Penal Code. There's enough provisions that you have today to take action against act of force. They are only bringing in this law to target. When they started speaking about this law, the attacks on the Christian community increased dramatically. This is what we have seen. This is only a way of bringing in, interfering in the rights of people. With the cattle slaughter bill, they brought in the cattle slaughter law. The attacks on Muslims increased dramatically. That is the only reason. So what a person eats, who a person will love, which religion, which God I'll believe in, will be decided by the state. That is what the state is saying. They have no business doing this.
The disadvantage is nothing. It is among us throughout the country. What few, 3 or 5 states have done, and they have come under the stuck of Honorable Supreme Court of India too. But the advantage is whether it is required. Advantage is that somebody is paying money, inducing them by coercion, by force, by the sword of their force, by their strength, they are converting them for the purpose of the religion as a mission and for the purpose of election as a political party. That is prevented by the way of this bill, has to be prevented. That was not there. That kind of action is there since post-independence too. It is not new action they are bringing. But this disadvantage is, whether you have done, whether you have converted with your own wish or not, that is different. The police can start commence their kind of FIR. Enquiry is commencing by way of registering the FIR, crime number. So there one crime number is born. Now you have converted. Now you want to go to America or Arab or somebody else as an employee, to see your father, to son, then the FIR will be there. It is unnecessary. But whether you have converted, you have taken that mazhab with your willful thing, it will be proved. But if this bill and act gives the ways to the police to make thousands of cases in the name of FIR, nobody can travel, and they have to face the criminal courts, so that it is unnecessary, unwarranted, because the coercion kind of thing, the force, by the force of thing, anything happens in our state, it is a crime. Not only this conversion.
हमारा constitution हमें नहीं बोलता कुछ forceful conversion के बारे में. वो बल्कि हमें हक देता है कि right to practice, profess and propagate religion का हमें हक देता है. और इस हक से हमें बाबा साहब अम्बेडकर की बात को भी याद करना चाहिए, जो बोलते हैं कि लोग हिंदुइज्म को छोड़ेंगे क्योंकि अनटचेबिलिटी जो इतनी ज़्यादा अंदर घुसी हुई है हिंदुइज्म में, वो उसकी वजह से लोग इस हिंदुइज्म को छोड़ेंगे, और बल्कि उन्हें छोड़ना चाहिए. ये ऐसा बाबा साहब अम्बेडकर ने हमको कहा है. और इस बात को याद में रखते हुए हमको ये डर इसीलिए है क्योंकि इस कन्वर्जन बिल से और भी ज्यादा लोगों को टारगेट किया जाएगा, माइनॉरिटी कम्युनिटीज को टारगेट किया जाएगा.
आरएसएस, हिंदुत्व, बीजेपी आर डिसओन द क्रिश्चियन कम्युनिटी, दैट इज हाउ दे आर ब्रिंगिंग. सो इफ इट इज देयर, इट इज देयर ड्यूटी टू कमांड द थिंग्स फ्रॉम दीस टू पार्टीज, फ्रॉम दीस पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज.
लोगों को ये है कि डर ये है कि विदाउट द बिल इतना हरासमेंट हो रहा है, इतना वायलेंस हो रहा है, इतना जो है लोगों पर जुल्म किया जा रहा है, तो विद बिल लीगल आ गई तो उसका वेपन बना के, उसको एक हथियार बना के कैसे लोगों को टारगेट किया जाएगा. वो रीज़न है कि ये बिल को जो है हम रोकने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. जैसा कि वो लोग बोलते हैं कि अगर कुछ गलत नहीं है तो वो बिल से क्यों डरते हैं. हम लोग बिल से डर नहीं रहे हैं. हम लोग बिल गलत है, उसमें डरने की क्या बात है. हम डर रहे हैं इसलिए नहीं बोल रहे. ये बिल बिल्कुल गलत है, इसलिए नहीं लाना चाहिए. इसमें क्या होगा कि और ज़्यादा वायलेंस होगा, और ज़्यादा अटैक होगा माइनॉरिटीज़ के लिए, तो इसमें और जुल्म होगा. कानून की आड़ में जो है और जुल्म करेंगे, इसलिए वो बिल को हम रोकने की जो है कोशिश करेंगे.
आवर रेस्पेक्टेड बम्बई गवर्नमेंट केम हियर, व्हाट इज द नीड, व्हाट इज द नेसेसरी ऑफ स्टार्टिंग दैट, व्हाट ऑल अदर बिल्स दे हैव इंट्रोड्यूस्ड. One bill was introduced, the anti-house letter by the B.S. Yediyurappa, and Bommai is the conversion. Now, love jihad, many things will come. Whether in Karnataka, the booming state among us, the India can states, and in the state, Bangalore is one which is recognized by the world countries. Here, in such kind of culture, what is the need of these bills? What is the kind of prevention? Though, so the prevention means they have to control the people. They have to make lot of crime registration. So it is the agenda of, if it is a Hindutva, And if it is not the agenda of the Hindutva, the major point of doing in this moment of his 3 to 5 months time and the Ahit election of 2023 and 24, what is the benefit to them? Otherwise, what they have seen, such kind of a thing, where there are thousands of people, Muslim converted as a Christianity, or Christian converted to Hinduism, or somebody have been arrested and they have abducted, they have been hijacked, they have been blackmailing for conversion due to their rights and all, nothing. There is no reference. There are no such cases in the state of Karnataka. Under crime, there are no cases. What made them to make? What is the reason behind this? They to make a bill. There are certain big reasons.
On the other hand, we have reason to fear that this law will be weaponized against the minorities' freedom of worship. We know what is happening in Noida. The Muslims are not being allowed to worship, you know, on their Friday in public places. Now they have issued circular in Karnataka. There is some districts have issued circular preventing Christians from assembling in halls. Why? And they say there will be law and order's problem. Whose responsibility is law and order? And for a peaceful act of worship, there is no violence, there is just mere people gathering and singing and praising. Why should that be a threat to anybody? So obviously, the law and order problem is not from within the Christians, it's from out. It's being generated and created from outside to intimidate the minorities. So we have the assurance nobody will have any problem, everyone can do their own thing, is not supported by what we are seeing. 39 cases in the past 1 year in Karnataka. People barging into worship services and doing bhajans. Will they tolerate it if anybody else? And now you are talking about force. Where is the force? These people are forcing themselves into churches.